Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we learn how to use Azure monitoring workbooks to get insights and visualize your data. And for that, we have Shikha Jain, who's going to show us how to do that. So thank you very much for joining us, Shikha.
Thank you, Leon, for having me here. I want to talk about Azure Monitor Workbooks, which is a new visualization tool that's available in the Azure Portal. So you're familiar with Azure Portal, and Monitor is something that's always available and always on for all the Azure resources. Jumping into Azure Monitor, you would see workbooks right here. And workbook has something called gallery, where you see the workbooks that I have already built and some of the workbooks that are available out of box to get you started. So one of the things that I'm going to do today is just start from scratch and show you how to quickly build a workbook. Here, I'm going to start with some of the data sources that are available in Azure Monitor. There is metrics and query goes against logs and application insights and other things. So let's start with metric first. In metric, I can select what resources. There's a whole list of resources that I can start with. I start with Cosmos DB account, and it gives me access to all the subscriptions that are available, and I can select a couple of resources. I know I'm looking for data not in last hour, but last 4 hours. So now let's start adding the metrics. And this is where you would be familiar with Metrics Explorer, and it would bring all the metrics associated with that resource type. So let's say if I had selected storage account, it would have given me metrics for the storage account. Now, one of the key things that I would say is for Cosmos DB, I just want to see how many requests are being made. And then for each of these, I also want to see how much data is being utilized. So let's just add these two metrics. And now, if I have multiple metrics, I just want to see it as a grid. So this is how quickly you can see an at-scale view. I could have added more of my resources and got the list, and I can keep adding metrics too. So it gives me a very good snapshot view. Now, since it's a visualization tool, I can also think about how to color code it so it becomes a better picture of how I want to see. So one of the things that you would see is for each of these metrics, it also gives me a timeline. Default, it's hidden. I can just go and say, okay, show me a timeline, and you would see the change that I see here. For the requests, you know, as it grows, currently it's zero, but some of them could run into millions and billions depending on the time range, right? So I want a more easier way to grasp the data. And for that, what we have done is we've given you different column renderings. And I can easily see a heat map and kind of choose the color template, and you would see the changes reflected here. So the highest one kind of gets highlighted. The other thing that is available also is customer formatting, because there are different types of data that you're dealing with. So you could do counts, percentages, time. In this particular case, it's just a count. So I'll just say represent in 1,000, and this is where you would see how the formatting style would be. And I could say, okay, I don't want any digits, and then I apply. And same thing goes for data usage. Data usage is in bytes, so I can say, okay, don't show me MIB. Like, I just want millibytes and megabytes, so I can go and select one of the things from here, which cleanly formats the data. And as you see here, I've done this. Now, the other thing I want to show you is, this is metrics. Now, I want to add data from query too. So one of the most common query that we use is Azure Activity. Like, it gives me activity analysis of everything that's happening. So let's start with that. I'll play a very simple Azure Activity. I'm just creating by level. Give me 7 days, what's happening there. Now, if I were to run this query, I would actually select a workspace. So let's go pick one workspace. So I am just going to select one of the workspaces that I know for sure has data. And then when I run this again, you would see it gives me information because I set the visualization that's set in query. Now, here is the beauty of workbooks, where I can go and change it to tiles. Now, when I change it to tiles, it's more readable information. And to add to it, I can also do some of the things that I wanted to quickly show you. There is a lot of formatting available here, and I can say, okay, this one represented as thresholds to me. So when this value is equal to, let's say, error, show me a whole list. We have a whole list of icons. and then we can go and apply here. So this is just a quick way of visualizing and building a narrative and a story that you want to tell for, you know, if you're analyzing a resource or you're debugging a problem across these resources. So it works both at scale and at a resource level, and it's very quick and easy. Like, I could spend another 15 minutes, and what I would get is something similar to a visualization that I have here, which is, if you notice, I've added parameters, which allows me to select multiple subscriptions instead of hard-coded subscriptions that I had there. And similarly, I can do different Cosmos DB accounts that I wanted and a time range, and the activity that I was building here. So the way you can find these is, again, go to Azure Monitor Workbooks. The blue one is the empty getting started. There are these templates that you can use, and the green ones are the ones that you create. And you can share these workbooks, you can pin them to the dashboard, so there is easy way to access it from Azure Portal as well.
This is great, Shikha. One question, how much does it cost?
So you would be surprised. This tool is free, out of box, available to you anytime you have data you can build and start using it from day one.
That's great. Thank you very much, Shikha.
Thank you.
So you heard it. Thank you very much for watching. Try this out. It's free. Let us know what you think, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.